That flame is just, it sounds auto-aiming on me. Like what? Dude, look at that shit. Better keep on moving. I want to collect that fucking thing in there. There's another Spider-Man in there. How can I not jump on it? Like, I can clearly see that there's that ring of power in there. But this just doesn't jump there. Can I get there from here then? I hope I can, because I'm gonna miss that slave or prisoner, whatever the death chapter. Okay, so it let me get here. I could see that stupid fly ring in there, wedding ring or whatever it is. It's nice how they made that like blocky lava pipe. I like this 90s kind of like ultra blocky stuff. I really like that kind of. Now it's kind of like in. People are making these PS1 style games a lot, like the graphics are imitating that kind of super blocky PS1 style stuff from the 90s. I like that kind of stuff, that it's a modern game, but it's made so that it looks like some kind of PS1 game. Okay, so this is a puzzle, I guess. Is that gonna grow back? Oh yeah, it's growing. So you have to keep using that kind of like jump from another one to another. Holy fucking shit, Pickle. Okay, I hacked this game. I didn't even get this far. The game let me through anyway. Yeah. Like you died earlier than where you got, so it's kind of like in some checkpoint levels you can just use that. Just fly that corpse of yours. Fly. Let the corpse fly high enough or far enough, and then you can just warp through the place. The game is just gonna let you get an extra checkpoint anyway. Okay, there's that old enemy of mine, Spider-Man. Oh, is that the Italian Spider-Man? It's like the Eurotrash version. That's why it's such a bitch in my head. Bitch, please. Please. Italian Spider-Man, please. Give me a chance, dude. Yeah! Eat shit and die, you piece of shit. Okay, that's that superpower again that I don't. This glove. The PlayStation 1 version didn't have anything like this. I don't remember anything. But this reminds me, this super glove, power glove from AVG, and reminds me of like Rayman 3. In Rayman 3, you can get all those different kind of gloves. So maybe it wasn't such a new idea after all. In this game you have this. It's changing the gloves to get a different power up. So in Rayman 3 it's actually really used a lot. Like the whole look on the character depends. It has a different glove on. So you get a different power up depending on what gloves you use. But I think Rayman 3 had some ideas, but I think overall it's a worse game than this. This is much better like this. Now let me see. I don't need to take it immediately. Let me see where does this bit of hell leads me. Okay, it's going down to hell apparently, so. Okay. Also, this is totally different. I don't remember anything like this of PS1 version, okay. Let's see how it goes. Well, it's a new experience. It's good because now I got more reasons to play this game because how am I supposed to get past that? Do I have to jump before I hit that shit? Okay, I'm gonna jump like next time. It's like it's a new gameplay walkthrough, but the game is so different compared to the PS1 version that it feels almost like I'm playing a different game. Okay, I can jump. What the hell, dude? I didn't even know that. I didn't jump at the right time. I don't know why do I keep you like how does it use those I lost two of those knuckles, Sonic and Knuckles. I guess there might be some kind of armor or something, maybe. I'm only thinking about that because the PS1 version, I don't remember anything like that, so. And I probably played through the PS1 version almost like, let's see, it must have been close to about. What? I was not supposed to die from that. Where's the fucking truth, dude? But at least I got a lot of health on the ES energy health bar. Also, the knuckles are like golden colored like the piss gold of the color in the ES energy drink. I keep advertising ES energy drink a lot here because it's part of the joke things in talk show ideas on, you know, certain kind of things. So you might hear more about that stuff later on. Okay, let's pay more attention to this. Okay, now I don't understand. How did I die in this part now? Like, maybe I just can't jump on it, I think. I think that's the problem. You just have to keep, like, let it fall down there. Like this, gently, like that. Be a gentle little bitch. Don't pinch it too hard. Or you might just pop the seed on it. Pop those things like you have a big ass acne going on. Okay, so what? So you can only hit part of the lava magma, but not the other part. That's kind of stupid. Like, it's almost as illogical as Doom levels. Like in some levels of Doom mod maps, you walk in there like acid and lava, but you won't take any damage or blood. And then in some levels, you do take damage. So you just have to kind of test which lava pit do I take damage from. There's this illogical thing going on. Here you don't want take damage, but here you do take damage. It doesn't make any sense. Like, why would there be any different kind of lava pits? That's stupid. And then also, if I jump on it, then it's gonna damage me. That makes no sense at all. You have to just do it the right way, you little bitch. Ass noob. So I am a noob. I really am a noob to this PC version because I have never seen these things before. This is totally first time for me. Only ever played the PS1 version, which was very different. What? What was that? I played it correctly. I still died. Maybe I had too much curve on the jump or something. Something stupid like that. If you like drop on that thing with too much nose touching the floor on that Möffer rocket, then you're gonna take damage anyway and die instantly. Stupid shit. Like, this is actually really hard. Like, it's so little thing that you need to. There's no room for fucking up. Little bit of fail and you're gonna die immediately. At least I don't lose too much health bar on ES Möffer. It must be Möffer, like some kind of molten Möffer. That's why it's being such a bitch on me. It's not really lava, it's Möffer. It all makes sense right now. Burned Möffer. Let's blame it on that one. That's why it doesn't make any logical sense why you take damage. This game seems to be lacking even on 30 FPS. Okay, it automatically jumped off. I don't know, automatically, and I had no clue why. Why did it not die? Because I think I fell down exactly the same way as I did last time. It doesn't make any sense, but at least I didn't die, so I didn't have to keep ranting and raging on that stupid shit. Spanks, dude. There's a bloom. And there's an asshole. Is there another place to go? Need to kind of check out the place. Okay, so there's two places I can go to. I'm gonna go to the... Gonna check the pyramid. Oh, what? Where did it go? Just disappeared. Illogical stuff continues. What? Wow, can I go here? Just without the plum. Is this the place where I already was in? This looks like the same place. But there's some loom in there. Some flying energy drink. It's like the... Need to collect some energy drink droplets that are flying on air like that. They're like the gas form of air. I think this is the same place, so I can't go here again. And because this game doesn't have any map, it's kind of like an action adventure platformer, but it doesn't have any map, so I have no clue where I am. If I don't know exactly what this place is, there's no map to see where you are, so I had no clue to know where would I go from that door. You need to just know, remember all of those places, go through them 10 times to see what's going on. No other way to know what's going on. It's kind of like the typical 90s stuff, that games had some really hard things going on. Having a mapping game was just too easy mode. They thought it was gonna make the game suck or something. Too easy. Make some map with some auto aim to show exactly where you are and where to go. Like some arrow pointing. Go here, you total noob. Go here. Nowadays you kind of have that thing usually. Yeah, this is the same exact place. But I got one flying droplet of AS, so 5 out of 5. There's that auto-aiming flame of Möfö that is kind of like trying to. Yeah. So it's obviously it's Möfö. It's like it's this yellow pirate piss-colored Möfö energy coming out of that burning Möfö pit. Now I know. That's why it's being a bitch on me. It's not lava. It's melting Möfö. It's probably combined with some kind of robo cum. So that's why it's like that. You know, there's logic behind that stuff.